Championship 3 years ago, thanks to Cam Newton. And they're going to take on those guys, Florida State. Florida State, number one in the country, unbeaten, although they have not played the most difficult schedule. So there's a little food for thought there, all you Seminole fans. Congratulations on the unbeaten season. But we'll see how you handle the Auburn Tigers and that offense. Should be an entertaining game. Again, as these two battle, and the trash talking's already going back and forth. I want to welcome back my friend and colleague. She's got a brand new show on CNN. It's called Unguarded. Rachel Nichols joins us. Also back with us, our one-man justice squad, great criminal defense attorney Jeff Gold. Rachel, I'll start with you before I get into a couple of these tweets. It doesn't take long for an instant rivalry, right? Auburn, Florida, they're already going at it on social media.
Yeah, you got teams in two different conferences, but those are both southeastern part of the country teams. So you've got fans who maybe have family members going from one side to the other. People know someone at work who went to one school versus the other school. Plus, this game is still almost a month away. That is a long time ahead to build up a hatred for someone, and people are getting going on that. By the time we get to January 6th, they're really, really, really going to hate the guy next to him.
Yeah. And 30 days from the time they both played on Saturday till we're going to get the game January 6th in Pasadena. Hey, Jeff, you touched on it. Go a little further with just how immediately we've got divisions when you talk about rivalries and people go their separate ways in a hurry.
You know, look, this is rivalries on steroids in the day of the internet, Facebook and Twitter. A month is an interminable long time. Although these teams may not be classic rivals, by the time these games come up, you're going to hear an awful lot of trash. Like, think about it this way. FSU was in the first BCS championship and lost it. So they're in for that. Look at Auburn, Cinderella team, although they're a good team generally. Cinderella this year. So it has the makings of a great game, and with a month of trash talk, I think we'll see one.
Yeah. Here's some of those tweets. Seminole Nation, Auburn is top gun, not intimidated by war chants. Here's another one. This one's pro-Auburn. Does anyone else think that Auburn doesn't? No, this is anti-Auburn. Does anything? Auburn does not belong in the national championship. Here's one pro-Florida State. Florida State by 30. Hashtag national championship. Rachel, Florida State's the 8-point favorite here. What are some early keys to look for as we get ready for this one? Again, it's 30 days away.
Well, with Auburn, you've got to think, can they pull off the miracle again? They weren't even supposed to be in this game. Remember, even just going into the weekend, just a few days ago, forget the beginning of the season when they were at the bottom of the SEC, but just a few days ago, we thought the national championship game was going to be Ohio State versus Florida State. Yes, Auburn won the SEC, but they were still looking on the outside of that window until Saturday night when Ohio State lost the Big Ten championship to Michigan State. So suddenly Auburn is thrust into this game. No, they're not the favorite, but they've made a practice this entire season and certainly in the last month with two miracle game-ending plays of forcing the issue, forcing themselves into the conversation and winning when they weren't supposed to. So there's going to be a lot of buildup to this game and a lot of people who think even though it's projected to be a somewhat lopsided national championship that maybe, just maybe, Auburn can pull it off one more time.
Yeah, I mean, Auburn's been entertaining to watch. Let's face it, whether it was the miracle against Georgia, the improbable win against Bama, or putting up 59 this past weekend against Missouri, they have definitely been fun to watch. Jeff, you come at this as a fan, right? Do you like, and next year we're going to basically get a four-team playoff. Are you happy about that, that we're getting closer to a playoff now, Jeff?
Yeah, I am. I mean, college football is kind of haphazard, you know, from the days of Rutgers and Princeton to the, you know, the first college game to now has been a haphazard process of conferences and, you know, a lot of politics and a lot of money involved. And, yeah, I like to see it. The more regulated it is, the better. I'd like to see eight teams because I think it makes for a better sport, more regulated.
Okay. See, I'm with Jeff, and Rachel, give me the pros and cons. I like the eight-teamer, and I know it's difficult to schedule and all that, but let's just, even if you look at the eight teams that are still, or the top eight in the BCS now, I mean, round one, you'd have Florida State against Missouri. You'd have Michigan State against Stanford, Auburn taking on Ohio State, Alabama against Baylor. That's if you had eight teams. Do you think, Rachel, we'll ever get to an eight-team playoff like that?
I'm not sure. It is a tough go. It's fun in the NCAA tournament with the basketball teams, but that's a much different kind of endeavor. Scheduling football games is different. You can't have guys play back-to-back nights the way you can with basketball games. So if you were trying to do an 8-team playoff, it would create such a schedule problem for kids who are at least supposed to be student athletes. We all know that there's a little bit of a grain of salt that comes with that expression, but we'd like to at least try to put them in the position to be able to study, the position to be able to take their finals if, hey, maybe they wanted to. So to put them in an 8-team playoff, I think, would be difficult and honestly would probably not get us a different national champion. If the goal is to settle a national championship on the field, which I think, gosh, we all want, right? We all want them to play on the field to get to this game. Having 4 teams funnel into that one game, you're probably still going to get the same national champion than if you had 8 teams and you're doing it in a way that's more fair to these kids.
And just so if... Fast forward to next year, so it would be 4 teams left, Rachel, correct me if I'm wrong. It'd be Florida State taking on number 4, Michigan State, and Auburn and Alabama would have a rematch.
Although that would be going to be what's going to be interesting about this is that a committee is still going to be involved in picking those 4 teams. So everyone says, oh, the controversy is not going to be there starting next year. You can't say that. You can't say it would be these 4 teams. You're going to have a committee that's going to select the teams. So remember, no matter whether you're picking 4 teams for this event next year, whether you're picking the 64 teams going into the NCAA basketball tournament, there's always a bubble, right?
And someone's going to have a beef,
Who should be on the bubble? Who's the last one in? So we will still get all of that debate next year. It'll just slightly shift to a little bit lower down on the depth chart.
And at least you're going to get 4. And it's not, you know, maybe some unbeaten number 3 who's getting bounced out of it. But, Jeff, all this arguing, that's where you as a lawyer come in, right?
Yeah, we like that. We like that, Mike. That's all haphazard stuff. It makes for great arguments because there's human intervention. They pick these teams, you know. So that's why I say that I like to see 8 or more because, you know, there's less, you know, picking going on, and that leads to a lot of arguments. And there's families that don't talk to each other after Thanksgiving. You know, all the rivalry games, there's families that don't sit down to the table after a while. So, yeah, there's a lot of arguing in football as well as law.
Yeah, and the college game has definitely brought us that. Well, hopefully with the 4-team playoff next year, you know, we still get, you know, all the magnitude and all the big games during the regular season, plus you get the payoff with 4 teams getting after it at the end of the year. Jeff, thank you. Rachel, again, your new show, Unguarded, 10:30 Eastern, Friday nights on CNN. Thanks, guys. Appreciate
it.
Okay, let's take a look.